there's a faction of people in this country that are trying to convince black and brown communities that freedom of speech is somehow bad. It's a bad thing, that it works against us. And the truth is, freedom of speech is one of the most important tools that black and brown communities have. Mm-hmm. And there's this notion that if something's offensive, that it equates to hate speech and that it should be outlawed. If it's something that's distasteful, if it's something that is disagreeable, it deserves to be shut down. But that's not how
they're trying to shut us up.
That's not how speech works in this country. And you know, when you look at the Chicano civil rights movement and the civil rights movement in general, and they relied on that First Amendment protection to be able to make those changes. And so when we go down this road of censoring speech and censoring ideas, regardless of whether or not we agree with them, regardless of whether or not they might be distasteful, we're setting ourselves up for our own downfall.
What do you think about Title 42? Should we let it expire? Or?
Well, I don't think this is one of the reasons why, you know, I oppose Democrats, because I think that the difference between Republicans and Democrats is that Republicans are largely who they are on the surface. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't really pretend to like immigrants and a lot of these other things. The Democrats will smile and then stab you in the back. Ooh. And so that's one of the things. And you see, the treatment of immigrants is not that different under Democrat presidents or Democrat party. You still have, quote unquote, kids in cages. Yes. You still have a crisis that's happening. And so, you know, I think the way to solve the problem that's happening is that we need to streamline the process that it takes to become legal. Right now, it's so convoluted, it incentivizes people to come here illegally.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And so I don't blame people, because a lot of the problems that people are fleeing are problems that started because of the U.S., right? I mean, we're the ones shipping guns down there. A lot of the gangs that people are dealing with came from here initially, and then they grew. So I don't blame anybody for coming here. And I am a big believer that the two most important things to this country are immigration and speech. Those things are absolutely 100% integral to our country.